lots of great smallmouth if you're into it. Yeah, so I guess I can't say enough good things.
How's it going, dudes?
Good, how are you doing?
Good.
All right, we'll...
You ever been in the Boundary Waters?
We'll stop back by and chat some more. Okay, perfect. Enjoy.
Just check it out, man. If you like photography, shooting video, place to be. Northern Minnesota, right? You know, on the border there.
Okay. Where yeah, we're from Iowa. Yeah.
Iowa. Yep. Part of the continent.
Yep.
Sweet, dude. Yeah, so we started a podcast. We work at a radio station in a small town up on the border.
Okay.
We started a podcast all about the Boundary Waters.
Right on.
So if you ever want to learn anything about it, that's your ticket right there. That's be a good thing to listen to on the drive back to Iowa, too.
Oh, yeah.
Each episode's like an hour long, you know.
Okay.
15 right episodes so far. We're recording one right here at Canucopia, too. I think you'd find it interesting. Good hunting and fishing, you know, pretty much everything you need.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, man.
And it's on here?
Yeah, that'll get you to it. You know, if you scan this on your phone, it'll take you right to iTunes. But otherwise, just type into Google or something, you know, WTIP Boundary Waters Podcast, and you'll find it there.
Okay.
Yeah.
Sweet.
You guys going to hit the speaker circuit today?
Yeah, probably. It's our first time coming through, so.
Us too!
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, us too.
What
yeah.
do you think so far?
Pretty cool.
Yeah, man.
You were here yesterday.
Huh?
You were here yesterday? Okay.
Just this morning. Oh, yeah. You're just walking in, huh?
Yeah, we just drove up last night.
So. Yeah!
Hey, there's a lot of stuff going on. Have some fun, man.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, check out that podcast. Be good on your ride home.
Will do. Thank you.
Thank you.
This is like the most kayak I've ever
done. I didn't even have one myself.
Good, how are you doing? Some pretty good deals on his bag. 16 bucks, waterproof bags. Man, look at this white one. This white one. How are you doing?
The only one we have out is in here right now. Okay. Nice and lightweight. You could, but it doesn't have really a coating on it. It has like just a finished thing between and roll. But it does have a little foot pocket too, so nice and convenient that way. We do have ground covers available. They're called parachutes. Yep. Fantastic help.
And they each have a little corner inside as well. You can just put a rod on it. nice and handy. They're not waterproof, because that costs a lot of money. But they give you a great ground cover for parades, ball games, anything where you don't want to be sitting in the grass. It's a little strange to be talking about the beach today. But these will normally $39.95, so $40, and 15% off those. We will be here.
Good, how are you? I just think it's pretty easy to use.
Yeah.
I see a lot of people on them, and I've been curious about them. What about for weight-wise? Like, if I wanted to take, like, an overnight...
You want to take what?
Like an overnight hack to do some camping stuff.
Oh, yeah. I mean, for your size of weight, you can put about 250 pounds on one of those.
Really?
That's what this board's made for.
What's that?
That's what this board's made for.
Is it?
Expedition.
How heavy are they?
This one's about 28 pounds.
I do kayak and canoe. I've always been interested in these.
Yeah, it's a whole different experience being able to stand, get a different perspective on what the water looks like.
Get a whole different view.
You can see straight down.
That'd be nice.
How you doing?
Good. Have a question?
I do.
Okay.
To get that price down to $5, or we can just put a deposit down.
Dude, look at this little red one. Mad River canoe? Dude, that's like perfect size.
Thank you.
Okay.
We're from Iowa.
Iowa?
Yeah.
Whereabouts Iowa?
Huxley.
James.
So, oh, 2.5 hours ago.
I noticed this can go in the other way too.
Yep.
Have you seen our saws before?
I just bought one.
Yo, you just bought
one.
Okay, okay, great.
Not from you guys. I bought it through Bushcraft Outfitters.
Yep. Yeah, we sell to some resellers.
Yep.
Certain ones.
Yep,
we were in Cabela's, but we got out of Cabela's. They're not the right. They've changed too. They got bought out by Bass Pro.
Okay.
So close.
They sell clothes.
I bought it about 2 weeks ago, and it is best saw I've ever had.
Oh, have you tried it?
Yes, I love it. I mean,
I
go, I do like YouTube videos and stuff out there and pack a lot of gear. And
yeah,
the way it just folds down, it's just
good.
Man, it's
it
nice.
Fits in your pack, right?
Yes. Yeah. I mean, it is.
Great.
And it's
a
good
saw.
Do
you do a lot of YouTube stuff?
Yeah. Yep.
Where do you go? Like, what do you like to specialize?
Just kind of like bushcraft, camping
bushcraft
kind of stuff,
yeah,
you know, just kind of make shelters and stuff like that.
Do you have a website?
Yeah, I have a YouTube account that I just started up probably about 2 months ago.
Well, give us where, just what's your name or how to right here.
Retail sticker when they scan it.
Okay, great. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
pants?
I do. Good.
Oh my goodness, everything's so crazy.
It's gotten packed quick.
What's that?
It got packed quick.
Yes. Yes. Yeah, I gotta get my butt down to that speaker.
Thank you.
But yes, one bag, I originally was wearing that 3mm neoprene, like you're saying, I really had a struggle, a fight to get them off. These guys, very easy to get on, have an awesome Velcro, like that, not a normal Velcro, it's not going to get all messed up. Tight, lightweight, place book, 100%. Yes. Rarely happen. Not at camp, no. I've had some social care. Yeah, right, and that's the best case scenario. Not having food, odors, right? Cleaning your fish, on a rock out in the water. You know what I mean? No, I haven't really. I have come across bear and I've come across moose. I saw 12 moose on a 3-day trip in Algonquin about 3 years ago, and they needed to wall away. It was the farthest I got. But like, I paddled for 25 minutes around this guy. Water, and I can see literally I can see the bubbles coming off of his nose. That is so cool. But no, not in the Yes? I did a great slave lake this year. I caught a lake show, I think it was 17 pounds, but it looked like 30 pounds. Like it was a huge. Show you on my Instagram later. It's a really, really nice fish. Really nice place to fish. Probably within caribou because of the and that does be good. Put that inside there, and then on this side there's holes. And you take the Kevlar rope and you cross it through the holes on the back, and you just pull it really tight. And then you tie a couple double overhand knots there. Nothing's getting into that. And then you come up to a tree, tie it like this. Not any other way but this. This is the way you tie it around the tree. And you do two of those. Double knot around the tree. That tree can be this high. It does not need to be up in the air. That's the whole point. I wouldn't hang it in here. I have a video of a bear trying to get into this and getting discouraged and walking away. It's amazing. If they can crush your food. They can crush your food in this, but they do sell like aluminum liners as well. I don't find it necessary. I will even crush your food.
What manufacturer was that?
Ursac. You are set. Like Urso, Ursa. Maybe Jam Knot. I'll give you a rundown a little bit.
Okay. Funny.
I use 3 knots. I use the tall line, Maybe Jam, and then Joe Lynn.
Nighttime refreshment. You
got
so many. What's your best one?
Yeah, too many.
Light Bullet. Nice scotch. Nice smokes. $4.
Can you go over your cooking setup?
I can. 100%. I'll give you. 1 second. So, my cooking setup is very new. This is a Snowpeak 900 titanium pot, very common. The lid doubles as a frying pan. Frying pan sucks. Frying pan, you give it on you, it's not fun, burns everything. That's horrible. But it's a frying pan! This is great, this part of it is great. The lid works on top of the thing. This is extremely lightweight. This is a 900, like I said. And in my right hand, I have my face. That is my kit setup. It sits right in there. I'll cook all my meals on this, and whatever fish I catch, I will either use crappy frying pan to do oil, or I'll just put it over the fire. And that's the beauty of it, too. You always have fun. Most of the time. This is made in Alaska. This is a bush body stove. It's ultra light. It's stainless steel, not the cam. Super thin. This is gas fire stove. It burns the smoke twice. So it's very Doug again has